My name is Jordan Hylden. I'm from Columbia, South Carolina. I'm a priest at St. Mary's Episcopal Church in Columbia, in the Diocese of Upper South Carolina. I'm also a theology and ethics doctoral student at Duke University Divinity School, and I am a 2014 ECF fellow. My doctoral work focuses in, for my dissertation, on the work of some mid-20th century Catholic social thought figures. Primarily, I'm going to be looking at the work of the French-American Catholic philosopher Yves Simon, and then also Pope John Paul II. I was drawn to the work of mid-20th century Catholic social thought figures like Jacques Maritain, like John Courtney Murray, but particularly like Yves Simon, the fellow I'm going to be focusing in on, because they seem to me to represent a way of working from within the tradition of the Church Catholic, not just the Roman Catholic Church, but the Church Catholic, which really does claim a uniqueness for the body of Christ and her sacraments, the action of the body of Christ, of the body of Christ in the world. But they did so in a way. That began to look in a more positive light than had been the case in a very long time in the Catholic tradition at the possibilities of what God may be doing in, for lack of a better phrase, the secular city, in the city of man. What I want to focus in on more specifically in respect to Catholic social thought is applying that question to justice. How does the justifying work of God become primary and controlling in our talk and thought and work for justice in the world? How does our life in the church, the new creation, the body of Christ, become primary for our work in the world? Without swallowing up the world, without hiving ourselves off from the world, without neglecting the work that we are to be about. My hope is that as cultural Christianity wanes, which is a very mixed blessing, that we are drawn to look outside of ourselves and focus instead on the burning coal that God placed on the lips of the prophet Isaiah, the word that God gave to the prophet Jeremiah. Jeremiah did not experience success in his lifetime. He experienced exile. But what are we but you know, alien citizens and a people in exile, strangers in a strange land? Perhaps we can recognize that and find once again the power of the God who raises the dead.